Welcome to episode 4 of Chiptune Tech. My name is Anthony Hom. Chiptune Tech is created to disseminate information regarding the tech side of the house when it comes to chiptune hardware, mods, accessories, and all of the amazing innovations that people are doing to bring a brighter future to chiptune music. Om Nom Nom is a collective of musicians, artists, tech heads, and writers with a passion for chiptune music, retro gaming, and old computers. We aim to share information and our passion to all of you. If you are interested in submitting audio, video, or articles to Om Nom Nom, please send us an email at mikey@omnomnom.com. In this episode, I will be talking about the bass mod and noise filtering mod for the Game Boy Color. The Game Boy Color was the third offering from Nintendo in the Game Boy lineup. In our last episode, episode 3, we talked about the prosound mod for the Game Boy Color. The DMG01 Game Boy gets a massive boost in lower range frequencies with the prosound mod, while the Game Boy Color only gets a modest bump in its bass levels. The bass mod and noise filtering mod address these two issues. I first found out about the bass mod and noise filtering mod for the Game Boy Color from a post on chipmusic.org from a user named Scannerboy. In Scannerboy's post, they outlined the mods with only a few photos and sound clips, accompanied with some text. With this information, I set out to make a comprehensive step-by-step tutorial guide, complete with a materials list, tools list, and lots of pictures and instructions. The tutorial can be found on chipmusic.org. We'll have the link included in the annotations of this episode. The method I listed for the bass mod will yield a pre-pot bass mod, meaning you will be getting a line-level signal at 100% volume. The bass mod requires a steady hand and a fine-point soldering tip, as you will be soldering to surface mount components. The idea is to tap into the left and right audio channels before they pass through a set of surface mount capacitors in the audio circuit. You then introduce a 4.7 microfarad 16-volt non-polar electrolytic capacitor to both the left audio channel and the right audio channel. Non-polar capacitors are also known as bipolar capacitors. The last step is to wire the non-polar capacitors to an audio jack. You can wire them up internally to the existing stereo headphone jack, a 3.5 millimeter or 1/8-inch female stereo jack, or RCA female jacks mounted to the case of the Game Boy Color. If you are a bit creative, you can mount them to a 6.35 millimeter or 1/4-inch female stereo jack or an XLR female jack on your Game Boy Color. The following are audio clips comparing the audio from Game Boy Color running LSDJ with pre-pot ProSound RCA jacks and a Game Boy Color with pre-pot bass mod RCA jacks. The audio clips were not altered in post-production and were all recorded with the same settings. The first clip is recorded from pre-pot ProSound RCA jacks at full volume on a Game Boy Color. The second clip is recorded from pre-pot bass mod RCA jacks at full volume on a Game Boy Color. Thank you. The most noticeable difference is that the base modded Game Boy Color gave the audio track a definite boost in the lower range frequencies and reinforced the mid-range frequencies. The Game Boy Color tends to exhibit more static noise when being used with LSDJ compared to the original DMG-01 Game Boy. While the prosound mod does remove a good amount of static noise from the Game Boy Color's audio signal, there is still an amount of static noise present that might not vibe well with everyone. The noise filtering mod simply adds a 470 microfarad 6.3 volt polarized electrolytic capacitor to the power supply circuit. The capacitor acts as a small battery for the power supply to pull from on demand. I theorize this further stabilizes the power supply circuit in the Game Boy Color. The next three audio clips are comparing the static noise that is audible from the headphone jack on an unmodified Game Boy Color, a ProSound modded Game Boy Color, and a base modded Game Boy Color with a noise filtering mod. The audio clips were played from empty chains in LSDJ. All clips were amplified equally to give a representation of the differences between the levels of static noise. The first clip is recorded from the headphone jack at full volume on a Game Boy Color. The second clip is recorded from pre-pot ProSound RCA jacks at full volume on a Game Boy Color. The third clip is recorded from pre-pot base mod RCA jacks at full volume on a Game Boy Color with a noise filtering mod. In comparison, the ProSound mod reduced a great amount of static noise that is exhibited on an unmodified Game Boy Color. The noise filtering mod further reduces the amount of static noise, making it virtually undetectable at normal volume. The base mod and noise filtering mod make the Game Boy Color an extremely well-rounded handheld for composing music tracks on LSDJ. How you compose, record, and modify your Game Boys are all personal preference. There are chiptune artists that embrace the noise of the Game Boy Color and use it to their advantage stylistically in their music. If you are not going for a pristine sound with your music, recording from an unmodified Game Boy Color may work best for you. If you are interested in performing the base mod or noise filtering mod on your Game Boy Color, the link to my tutorial will be listed in the annotations of this episode. That's it for me. For this episode of Chiptune Tech, thank you all for listening, and again, happy modding.